What's good, y'all? It's Andrew. We're back with another one, man. The Culture Vulture Chronicles have been opened up again. Vlad TV. Hov, 1 Billy Plus. Why are we talking about the 80s and 90s when he was moving at work? Why? Why are we not talking about all the donations, all the help in the community? I don't know. We're going to get into it. Vlad seems to be going at him. Wack got a problem with that. We'll react afterwards. Appreciate y'all tuning in, man.
DJ Vlad is scared to sit down with me. And we're going to run content on Vlad. See, Vlad showed his hand. We need to pull that whole thing up. Go get that whole interview.
This
right here, this Vlad, I'm convinced. See, sometimes there's some people in the music industry that they're so, like, on their they're so neutral to where even if you don't like them, you can't not like him. And there's one name that I can honestly say that's been around forever, and that's Jay-Z. I watched him make his opponent his friend. He made Nas. You know what, Nas? We went at it nothing to get your deal, bro. I'm over here
you're running
Def Jam. Right. So Jay-Z is, I feel like when they say Wack, who, when it comes to that, is the most neutral, most likable in the music game. And I would honestly say Jay-Z.
He's a great business guy, bro.
You consider him a wolf?
No, I could, well, yeah, he's, I could say definitely that, but he's like, you gotta remember, even when it came to what he did for the culture for music, building an empire with Dame, I look up, even on this weirdo, the U-Visa program, 21 Savage, he helped him when Lil Wayne had tax problems. He did that, right? You know, when Meek Mills went to jail, you know, he utilized his voice and his face to help assist in that. So when I look up and a like Vlad go find some from 30 years ago to come do an interview and say, yeah, did you and Jay-Z sell together?
Oh, you talking about the Haven?
Listen, bro. What the f*** is you on? You know what I'm saying? Look, you don't even look. What is you on? And now this is when the people need to cancel about Vlad. Right? Why? Okay, I'm going to do this content on this dude who grew up with Jay-Z. And we're going to bring him on here right now. Where Jay-Z's at in his life. See, the last thing I saw in the headlines about Jay-Z is him and Beyonce buys most expensive house in Los Angeles.
$200 million.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Or Rock Nation. Brand.
Now, here this come with the Jay-Z was a dealer. Oh, Vlad, what are you on, bro? What I'm saying, like, what are you really on? So at this point of Jay-Z's career, what he's doing in life, your content is, let me bring a dude on here that says Jay-Z sold. This is like my that. Point. He rapped about where he come from. 444 was a game changer for me, right? So it's like, I'm just like, yo, Vlad, what's your real intentions with us, bro?
What's your angle?
Yeah, well, I see what you're saying, because Jay-Z done did like a million other things since then. He done did like a million other things.
So far away from that.
Yeah,
you don't see him. You don't see him doing the Suge Knight running around with 50 goons from Marcy Projects. The got dreads in the suit on, bro. Smiling, chilling. Doing a deal, and then when the camera comes on, he giving us business game.
Okay, I see exactly what you're saying.
You know, like, for real, his last albums, listen to what he's rapping about. He's rapping about his mistakes. I brought a Benz when I could have went and invested in this. I did this when I could have went and did that. Today, that's worth nothing. Today, that million would have made me $300 million. Like, you know, like, even when he addresses Dame, he does it with taste and respect. He did what he's supposed to do. He told Dame, pipe down, you f***ing the business up. Dame want to play. We going to make them do what we make want to make them do. JG going to say,
luck with that.
You're not going to make these people do a thing. We're going to join forces, or I'm going to join forces, so we can do a bunch of things together. So Jay-Z went his way.
Yep.
Bro, we had our run. We can't keep running like this.
It's crazy.
People are forced to deal with you because of me, and they want to deal with me, with you, but the way you dealing with them, they ain't with it. I'm not going to be lying, though.
I love it.
I'm not going to lie. They was playing Dame close.
They were.
Oh, Dame and cut him out. But Jay-Z was already making his move because he was allowing them to have access to him. Probably based on, like, yo, man, we scared of this dude. You know what I'm saying? So, no, I've seen it. And even right now in the day, if Dame humbled himself, he could have been doing some business. Kanye loved Dame Dash, but he noticed Dame, he'd have went to the Adidas meeting acting crazy.
Well, there it is, y'all. I'm going to tell you something. Not just Vlad, though, but a lot of us. I don't know why we be tearing down our people that have made it. No other culture does it. We need to be, everybody has flaws. Nobody perfect. But when our people reach a certain status, why are we looking for holes in their game when they done overcame those and got to those prominent positions? Let's celebrate them so more people are encouraged to get to that level and pass it back. So anyway, man, we'll see how this story develops. Apparently, they're going to run a story on Vlad. We'll bring it to you. It's your man to answer, like, comment, subscribe. We out till next time.